Hello everyone, welcome to a very hot Cyprus where we are hoping for some equally hot action as the seniors take centre stage in the skeet competition. It was very tight in qualification. We have a very high quality field today to see if who can take the European title and of course a precious Olympic quota place. We start with the women's competition alongside me, Martina, who's been holding the fort very well for the last, 10 days or so whilst I was also away, but it's nice to be back. Not sure about the heat though. Goodness
it's me, it's nice. Warm, isn't it? It's definitely nice having you back to be on the, I would say, hot seat right now because that's how I feel. But I think we're starting already. First we have a athlete from Finland, Marjut Heinonen, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, just a reminder, we get 8 people into the finals, 2 ranking matches, of course, and Marjut Heinonen qualifying in 8th place. The 45-year-old Amber Hill will be in the second ranking match as well. The Great Britain athlete, who's 25, qualified 6th. And how about this for a reception for Constantina Nicolaou of Cyprus? She qualified very well in 4th place, European Championship silver back in 2016. But they are up against the woman who's a 2 times European champion, the Olympic bronze in London. And Danka Bartikova has a great chance here, of course.
Okay, that's going to be ranking match number 2. Now we're going to have the ranking match number 1 athletes coming out. First from France, Lucy Anastasio, 29-year-old. She has a gold from a European Championship in Baku.
Yeah, 3 career golds. And, she's got a chance, of course, as all these athletes. They have to get through to the medal match first, up against Barbara Sumová of the Czech Republic, the 27-year-old, bronze at the European Championships, 3 years ago now. But we do have a couple of real big names in this first match. Diana who qualified 3rd and 1st. First of all, the Italians always in with a chance, aren't they? Diana Baccozzi, the 39-year-old, a woman who has an Olympic gold from Rio, a silver from Tokyo, very nearly made it back-to-back gold medals there. But the best in a European Championship, 4th. So a chance for a first medal on this stage for her. And Nadine Messerschmidt of Germany. She'll be 29 next week. A birthday present, perhaps. A gold medal here. Well, she got the World Cup gold in Nicosia a little earlier on. And she will be ranked number 1 of all these 8 athletes. It was a very interesting qualification. Messerschmidt with 119 out of 125. Bartikova ahead. And then we had, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on 116. And then, let me count them up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on 114. So right down to 13th place could have made it as we look at our officials. It's pretty breezy out here at the moment.
Oh, yeah?
It is hot, but it is breezy, and that will be
a lot of wind.
Yeah, more of a concern for the skeet athletes than it was a while back for the trap athletes, I think it's fair to say, because obviously, it looks to me from the side officials' flags that it is blowing from right to left, but we will confirm that. The wind turbines, actually, they're moving a little bit faster than that. I think we've got a bit of an artful slow motion there. But 34 degrees. Even the locals are saying it's hot. These athletes are used to it. But, of course, a couple of days of qualification. And then if you're lucky, you'll get into these ranking matches. And if you're lucky, then you'll get into the final as well. So, it's certainly a long old haul for these athletes. That's the stats and the facts and figures for you. And of course, all things are the same when it comes to these informations on the shotgun. But of course, you can sort of personalise it, certainly with the decorations, the superficial stuff. Anyway, there we go. There's a reminder of how it works then. We go from shooting positions 3, 4 and 5. There are 20 targets first up. That's 2 times around. And we lose our 4th place athletes after 10 targets. More, we lose our 3rd athletes, and the last 2 standing go through to the medal match. We'll go through the medal match a little bit later on.
Only 2 of the ones that we see on the screen right now are going into the medal match, which is a little bit better than before. Before, only 6 of them were able to even compete for the for the medals. Now we have 8 of them competing, and that's how it's going to be at the Olympics as well.
Yeah, all the way through to 2024. We headed to Paris then, of course, and just a reminder that the top two, once the dust has settled, will be taking a very precious quota place. So not just European glory, but also a chance to dream the dream of Olympic medals as well.
And I think that's double of being nervous for this competition, for these athletes. But some of them already have been to the Olympics or have won some medals at the Olympics. So we have some strong competition here at the European Championship.
So the test fire is done and dusted. We are about to get underway. Remember, two doubles from the station number 3, a pair from 4, and then the reverse of what we see on station 3 on station 5. So we start with the high house, low house, and then the reverse here. And it's always the tricky one coming out of the high house on the reverse. This one here, what can Messerschmitt do? Hand goes up. I wonder if that was a problem with the targets. It's very, very hot here, and just occasionally these targets do stick together. Axel Kramer would have seen it all, of course, very experienced. And there is the miss, as almost predicted, from the high house. It's a lot more difficult in terms of tracking that one out the high house. Andrea Benelli. Another very experienced coach.
Yeah, we've seen him in the juniors finals as well these last couple of days.
So, just getting into the swing of this first ranking match. If you're just joining us, it's lovely to have your company. I hope you've been joining us all the way through. We've had a great run of juniors, looking at the champions of tomorrow when it comes to the seniors, but now at the sharp end, the seniors. We were discussing in the trap, weren't we, competition, how some of the gold medalists in the junior competition have come through and found themselves in finals in the senior competition in just a year. Osijek last year, now here in the heat and a little bit of humidity as well. Sumova, a good start.
Petr Zvolenek, the coach. It's a little bit different shooting in the individual and the team events, where the coach and the athlete can't really speak to each other. We've seen some of the... That's going to be two missed targets.
Yeah, double miss from Sumova. We were just bigging her up. The fact that she's a double Olympic medalist doesn't mean you can't start with a wobble.
Absolutely. But it doesn't mean you can't come back from it as well.
Well, better perhaps, never a good time to do it, but do it early, and then at least you can settle down.
Oh, yeah.
If you've got the mental fortitude, of course.
Absolutely. One of the most important things in this sport.
Well, here's the French woman from La Rochelle. Very glamorous. And also misses that one on the reverse. No one getting that one at the moment. So we go round. Station number 4, position 4. And this one should be the easiest of all the stations, but under pressure, you never know, with them coming from an equal angle.
Yeah, shooting just one double. In this round, that's going to be a normal double. High house, low house.
Well, we'll see how they do. It is warm out there. They had to wait. There's a slight hole before we got underway. But we mentioned this as well. It's a physical sport. You've got to be out there day in, day out. And there is a miss from Messerschmitt. Well, 2 reds to her name now.
Yeah, the men are going to have a competition a little bit later. But I think this is a very hot moment to be in the sun. It's not easy for the women breaking the ice in this case. in this very, very hot weather.
Well, it's a luck of the draw, isn't it? If you're in Linato and it's May, you might want to start because the shadows lengthen, the clouds might roll over, the vision might not be quite so good later on. But here, yeah, you're definitely the ones who are going to be roasting, not just, of course, the T-shirt, but also the shooting gilet as well. And that's another miss. We've got a lot of reds on the scoreboard at the moment. At the moment, Messerschmitt, Bocozzi, 4. Sumova with 3. A chance here for Anastasio to go into the lead. She misses one, but she will just, get the 4 and has an equal chair.
It looks to me that she thinks that was a hit. Oh, yeah. That's going to be a video assistant referee right there.
VAR for the first time. On goes the headphones.
Let's go. I like to do the statistics to see how many VARs come out as a hit.
Just guiding our jury member in charge the long way around. A little bit congested our end of the officials' table. The referee will wait. He will wait for the three wise officials. There they are. TV screen shielded from the sun to see as well as they can do. We will hopefully see the same pictures you will see. And certainly we will wait on this one. And the athletes will wait. They're all ready to head around to station number 5. All right, let's have a look and see what we can see.
Not much from this angle.
Not much from this angle. We will hopefully get a better angle.
Yeah, I'm sure we will. We just need to wait for a second. In the last competition 2 days ago with the juniors, team men, the VAR actually decided on the win.
Here we go. Well, that one is definitely a hit. I think it's the side.
That's a hit. And that definitely then is. Coming back on the other side, let's see. I don't know.
It's a difficult angle to decide. But what is interesting from that angle is watch the athlete and how quickly they have to change tack and change direction. I mean,
even in slow motion, it looks very fast.
Of course, the here we go, thumbs down.
Okay, it's a miss.
I mean, if you can't see, it continues with a miss. And I think that might have been the decision there.
They decided very quickly on that one.
Okay, so there we are, 4 hits for all 3 athletes, bar Sumova, who is 1 hit behind. Remember, we go round again after station 5, and then we will know who takes 4th place in this first ranking match. So remember, we are reverse sequence to what we saw at station 3, and this time it's the low house that causes the problem. It'll be set up for the high house, and then we'll have to wheel back left. Took her time, did good.
I think that's the first time 4 in a row, huh?
Yeah, we've not had the smoothest start to this competition as far as the athletes are concerned. It makes it exciting for us, of course. They wouldn't want it to be too exciting, let's be honest.
Was that just one?
I think there may have been a no target. A little look across.
Okay, the coach is having his opinions on that one. That was no target the end. Okay, so we're rolling back. Coming again to it.
Another
again? I don't know if you feel it, but the air is super heavy. They're saying it might rain, and we know what happened last time.
I heard. I wasn't here.
Yeah.
We had thunderstorms and torrential rain for the 4 days before I came up here. It was a tricky trip up to the airport, but I hear it was nothing compared with your 5 minutes of purgatory.
It was more like 25 minutes.
Oh, was it?
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Was it 25 or did it just feel like 25?
I don't know. I don't really remember anymore by the time. Yeah, you're right. It could have been less than that. But it definitely got everything in it to look like a swimming pool.
Well, I think we're just on the safe side of the bus shelter, as I call it, we're underneath.
I mean, let's hope.
I arrived back. I said to Martina, what's the mess on this desk. Oh, it's just the congealed dust after the rainstorm. It's not coming off anytime soon either.
Looks like there's a little bit of a bigger problem with the target. So we have the technicians coming in. Some of the athletes are trying to shield themselves from the sun as best as they can.
Yeah, Nadine Messerschmidt has just sidled up to us into the shed. I don't blame her either. We're just waiting. Obviously, a slight issue. And we did say sometimes the atmospherics affects the targets. They can stick together. They're quite fragile as well, so you've got to be careful how they're transported. You don't want them cracked because they'll come out.
Not just transported, but put in the machine. Sometimes they have to check each and every single target.
Well, they were, and to be fair, obviously proper preparations. They did test before the competition got underway, but that's life, isn't it? There we are, the Olympic champion from Rio. Almost the Olympic champion from Tokyo. Not quite. Not quite.
Walking in the sun.
She doesn't mind, does she?
No, she looks very, very calm.
About the only way. Everyone else is headed for shade, I think.
Yeah, we can't really see a lot from this point in this moment.
There's Simova. She would have enjoyed her moment in the sun at the European Championships in Lonato. What a fabulous venue that is, and what a great competition that the guys and women there put on for us. Very proud of what they do. And Cyprus the same. Very big sports shooting contingent. Perhaps punching above the weight. There she is, just to the left of us, keeping her out of the sun.
Did you see how they cleaned the targets just before the finals? You didn't? I love it. Every time I come here, I just hear a loud noise, and I look up, and it's the leaf blowers.
Oh, yes, I know. I did see that. I thought you meant they were in with a little brush down in the traps and the houses. No.
I mean, I didn't know that the leaf blowers can work so well on the targets as well.
It's just lazy, isn't it? What's wrong with a brush? What's wrong with a brush?
And you see a nice frame around the green grass, yes. The orange frame.
Yeah. Well, European champion, of course, last time. It was a bit cooler in Osijek.
Oh, yeah.
Certainly was. And, of course, it had both rifle and pistol and shotgun at those championships. So we got started early, finished late.
Oh, yeah.
Used to take the 3-mile walk back just to get some exercise.
I mean, that's very
town.
Smart.
Yeah.
And a little bit easier when, you know, it's not so sunny.
Absolutely. Well, they are baking. There is movement from the high house. A couple of the Cyprus club officials running around making sure everything's okay. There's a few signals between, just behind us is the official who makes sure the targets and the scoring system is right. It's a shame that we've got this delay. But
yeah, but these things happen. I mean, it's not something that the athletes are not used to. This is a little bit prolonged. But it definitely, we can see when they come back who was able to stay in the focus, especially in this kind of a weather with these conditions.
Yeah, and these athletes are used to delays. I don't know if there's any umbrellas. If there are any umbrellas, probably none in Cyprus in its entirety. But that's what you need—a little heat umbrella.
I mean, because the rain, even if it comes, it's 20 minutes of rain and that's it. After the competition that day, we went to the city and everybody was just all, and everybody was blaming the rain. Oh, it rained today, you know, we're just, we lost our heads a little bit. So it's not something that doesn't really happen in Cyprus a lot.
There's not a cloud in the sky. I'm calling it that it's not going to happen.
All right. I'll take your word for it. I hope that you are right, but we'll see.
Well, it's hats for shade rather than keep the rain off at the moment. And our jury member and our referee in conversation. Our athletes, I think, have headed off to the left-hand side just to try and get a little bit of shade over. There is a shade to the left-hand side of the picture. You can see where they have to check in on time and make sure everything is working properly. And there we are in the shade. And we will just make sure and everything is working. Get some more water.
Yeah, hydrate for this moment, absolutely.
And we will take a little pause. We'll be back as soon as we're back on the field of play. That should only hopefully be a couple of minutes, but the door to that high house is still open. That one's just flown left to right. Let's see if we can get two in a row. Oh, the door is shut. Thumbs up. That's good news. Perhaps we don't have to pause after all.
I imagine him going manually there now.
No, he's run down. He's run down. he has down. Confidence.
Oh, okay. Oh, they're coming back. All right. Just as we could have taken the pause a little bit earlier. I'm sure the problem would have been resolved.
Here they are. Athletes coming back. Where were we? Station number 5 on that first round. Remember, when we get to 20 targets, so the second time around, we'll know who's taken 4th. Then another 10 targets, so one more time around those 3 stations, we'll know who's taken 3rd and who progresses to the medal matches.
Referee is checking just once again.
We've just got to make sure that the rotation, the scoreboard is at the right moment, because I don't want to give anyone a red when they shouldn't have. Right, just to say, it's Bocosi then. Messerschmidt got hers away. Bocosi kept shooting the one from the low house, couldn't get the one from the high house because it wasn't appearing. Let's keep our fingers crossed. We're underway again. And there was a target from the high house. Thank goodness for that. And it was dispatched. Well done, Diana Bocosi. Now she has to set again. This time looking at the high house first, then swinging to her left, looking for the one from the low house. She took her time, but she had time. Excellent from the Italian. What mental fortitude from her.
Currently, Sumova is on the line, let's say, but we still have 10 more targets after this, before the first decision.
Oh, she got herself ready, broke the shotgun again, and now she's ready.
30 seconds.
Misses the one out of the high house. It did come. So she's not having a good day at the office so far. 4 misses from her. Everyone else at the moment on 2 misses, although we still have Anastasio to come. She's not having a smooth time at this station. Let's hope now she can get the target she wants when she wants. She has pulled and just gets a nibble of the one out of the low house.
She is the youngest one, right, in the ranking match. 27.
Anastasio, 29. Messerschmidt, 28. Sumova, you say 27, and Bocosi, the veteran at 39. Been there, done it all.
Oh, yeah.
Nicely done from the Frenchwoman. Looked very at ease there.
Okay, Sumova is not in a good position right now, but again, 10 more targets could change a thing or two.
Yeah, it just takes someone to have a double miss, perhaps. That's the tail of the tape at the moment. And, it's close, the first 3.
Absolutely.
Couldn't be closer, but Sumova, with a bit of work to do as we head round again to station number 3. And we are about to get underway. Our German athlete, the woman who topped the qualification by some distance, a couple of shots. Some distance in shooting terms.
She's one of the rare ones who didn't have to go through a shoot-off.
Well, and that would have helped. A little less fatigue, of course. Sit up in the clubhouse, have your food, get a bit cooler. Although, notice it's not air-conned up there. It's all open. Our offices are air-conned. That's where I head to, straight away. Well, she is in decent form, isn't she? She missed that double miss. The 4th one from the first station and then the first one from the middle station. And since then, that is, 9 in a row.
Only hits from her so far. Now to Bocosi.
She's found some form as well.
I heard the target hit the fence, but...
Well, it only takes a nibble, doesn't it? And these referees are eagle-eyed, and they've got a couple of line-side referees. Of course, being skeet, they've got the two flags to indicate the double miss if they have to.
Right. Now we're talking.
Yeah, right in the centre for Sumova. That's better. That's the athlete we know. Ooh, that one careered away.
I was looking at the side referee, but no flags, flags went up.
Well, I think it careered away because she hit it. From where we were, it didn't look like there was any contact, but there certainly must have been. And that's why we've not got the flags in our hands. Give it to the professionals or the willing amateurs.
All right, this was a nice station for all of them.
Yeah, getting back into it. Just starting to perhaps feel it, get the conditions. It is breezy out there. A lot of electricity being generated in the, 20 or so turbines around us. We only see two from our finals position, but there's a lot behind the athletes. You can see it when you, nice long delay on my flight heading in, but as we touched down at 4 o'clock in the morning this morning, we could see all the red lights dotted around the island. You know where the shooting range is, just because you know it's somewhere in between it all. Nicely done. Messerschmitt is looking very comfortable, and as long as the others keep going, then it has to be said that Sumova has an issue, has a problem.
Absolutely,
running out of targets.
She can count on some. She can only count on somebody else have a double miss, but that means that she has to move on with all the hits, and that's not.
Well, it's out of your hands, isn't it? And that's not where you want to be. But
absolutely.
At the same time, of course, you also know that you have to keep hitting. And well, do you look at the scoreboard or do you not? Some athletes always have a little glance. Some athletes just
turn around.
Yeah, just don't bother. And there is a miss. And that might be that.
No.
Three behind now. The leaders, Messerschmitt, Bocosi, Anastasio, with a chance to join them on 14. Ooh, was that a miss?
Oh,
yes, it was. It was a miss. So, well, it's not mathematically impossible.
We move to station five, the last station of series one.
But yeah, if we look at it right now, Messerschmitt was first after the qualification, Bocosi was third, and that's more or less what we see here currently.
Yeah, nothing's changed. Nothing's changed. Just the misses on the reverse, the second one on that middle station. Now we come to station five. Now we get to the business end. We will see who's going to take their seat next to their coach in the sunshine and watch the rest of the proceedings. Well, German coach sitting pretty. Messerschmitt looking good at the moment. That was a low target from the low house, lower than you might expect. Perhaps just pushed down a bit by the breeze. No problems for the 28-year-old. I think just, 5 days away, something like that, from her birthday.
Maybe it's going to be a lucky day for her. Okay, Bocosi now with this one miss.
Well, certainly hit those centre. So she is just one behind Messerschmitt. We're starting to see it sift through, aren't we? All four from Sumova needed. And then just see if Anastasio has a terror time at station number five. We will see. She's doing her part of the deal at the moment. This is the trickier one of the two pairs, though. And she does very well. So 15 for her. It might come down to bib number. Remember, Anastasio with 7 on her bib from qualification. She needs to hit 3.
Yep. Oh.
And she needs to hit 2 here. Pressure is on. So we did say for Sumova, well, she's only missed 1 in the last 12.
Oh, is that going to be
a miss from Anastasio? And it's 15 for her. 15 for Sumova. The Frenchwoman can't quite believe it. It is her who will have to make way.
I mean, it wasn't looking like that. But you see, in a split second, right down at the last moment.
Well, especially with that miss from Sumova in that station number
four, we
actually thought that might be that. Yeah. However, this is sport. This is why we love it. You never quite know. So Sumova stays in. And that is how it is looking. That was so close, wasn't it? And that's the importance of qualification. They were both on 116. Anastasio seventh.
Yeah.
Sumova fifth after the shoot-off. Anastasio just, I think it was just one shot before she missed. So it was tight. But that's, you know, on another day, it could have been different. But the shoot-off, that's why they're so important. From third down to seventh, from Bocosi down to Anastasio, all on 116. And, well, Sumova will be happy that she managed to scramble into fifth place. Another 10 targets. We will then know who will take fourth place, then we'll have the next ranking match.
Yeah, but Sumova needs to step up the game here if she wants to be in the medal match.
And Messerschmidt had been cruising, but that miss, a little bit uncharacteristic, certainly from the first one. Perhaps she's feeling the pressure a wee bit.
Oh, yeah. She just saw what happened to Anastasio.
Like Cyprus, though. Gold in the World Cup in Nicosia, of course. I was going to say up the road. It's a bit more than up the road, but still part of this. Very different weather, of course, in Nicosia.
Absolutely, yeah.
We were talking when we were having a chat during the trap competition that it was almost snowing up there.
Oh, yeah.
A hint of snow.
The vegetation is completely different. Everything is green. You can see here that everything is burnt from the sun.
Good from Bocosi. Sumova. Wow. She got her get-out-of-jail card. Can she capitalize on that and make it into the final?
Okay.
So far, so good.
And the reverse one now, is that going to be okay?
Yep, two hits, two good hits as well.
All right, she came to 19. That's two targets.
Well, anything's
still
possible.
Have six more, huh?
And she was in the same position, of course, a few targets ago, trying to stay in this competition. So let's see. This is an important station. You want to bag both of these because you want to head to the last station, station five, where there are four targets on offer in the best possible shape. Messerschmidt here.
And the good thing for Sumova here is it doesn't really matter about the beep number now, because if they come to an end and they're tied, it's going to be a shoot-off. That's Messerschmidt with this one miss.
Well, you see, both of those targets, she's almost home and dry, isn't she? I wonder if Messerschmidt is just feeling a little bit at the moment. Bocosi, well, hasn't really done much but hit since her wobble. Everyone was wobbling early on, weren't they? First five or six targets.
But I'm sure Messerschmidt wants to go into the medal match. Last Olympics, she was fifth, so close to the medal. And now she can get a quota in just the beginning of the cycle. I mean, that's the best time to get one. And then you can just cruise on the other competitions knowing what you have in your pocket.
Assuming the Federation gives you the...
Oh, yeah, of course. But, you know.
It's in the gift. You get it for the nation, not for yourself.
Yeah.
Some countries say, well, you get it, you're going. You know, other countries don't. Nicely done, by the way, by Messerschmidt.
But you kind of expect it, you know.
Well, just one here and she's through. Do you think she should be favourite? But you're also looking for your best target, best number you can, because, of course, then that translates into your bib number for the final match.
Yeah, of course. Well, Bocosi has a chance to have the highest bib number now if she does well with this...
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it? Things have changed around. Messerschmidt just stumbling a little bit towards the end. But she knows she's through.
Yeah, she's safe now.
And it is going to be Sumova who will miss out. Can't get five targets from this station, much as you'd like to. Nicely done. Because he will take first place in this ranking match by a couple.
27 out of 30. Yeah. Really good. Good way to show the competition what they're going in with.
Handshake with Messerschmitt as they watch Sumova going through the motions here. She did well to keep herself in the competition, but it's not been enough. And so it is Bocosi, it is Messerschmitt who will go through into the medal match. That is coming up very shortly. But we have ranking match number two coming up very shortly. There's confirmation of Sumova being ruled out. Messerschmitt, Bocosi in the end were very, very accomplished indeed. And well, they will take on some liquids, I'm sure. Get the water down them and watch our next competition. That's how it's finished. Ranking match number two coming up.
When I'm lonely in the dark, I know you are with me. Yeah. Don't you see that I need you so much? Don't you see that I love you so
What do you pick the names of the four athletes in ranking match two? With bib number 8 from Finland, Manchut Heinonen. With bib number 6 from Great Britain, Amber Hill. With bib number 4 from Cyprus, Kostandia Nikolaou. Then with bib number 2 from Slovakia, Danka Bartegova. The athletes are having now a test fire.
Well, here we go then. The second ranking match, and it's an interesting mix of nations and experience. Marjut Heinonen, the 45-year-old, a couple of athletes in their 30s, Bartikova, Nikolaou, and then the 25-year-old Amber Hill, who seems to be around forever. Was it 7 years ago, I think, when she was a callow teenager, when she won the European Games gold in Baku in that marathon shoot-off. I think it was against Bocosi, actually, but if memory serves. But don't quote me on that. So Maud Heinonen, the 45-year-old, looking for her first medal.
Yeah.
None so far, but I'm sure she has the class, the ability, and of course Finland, a nation produced some very good athletes. Shop worker by profession from Ulensalo, was in Beijing at the Olympics. That's the only Olympics he went to, was inside the top 20, but no further than that, really. The World Championships, well, second, way back in 2010, was placed seventh.
But now in this competition, she was able to get into the first eight, having to battle off six of them in the shoot-off. They all had 114, and she's the only one who got in with that score. So,
well, I mean, yeah, she's already done better than she has done in the European Championships. 15th, her best in Lebersdorf 4 years ago now. So, yeah, well, it'd be interesting to see how she goes.
I mean, 45, and after that long of a career, now getting up to one of the best results so far, it really has a nice message to it of something along the lines, it's never too late, and stuff like that. So
never is, is it? Never is. If you keep yourself in trim,
oh yeah,
keep yourself focused. I mean, that's the thing, isn't it? Life gets in the way as you get older. Other things become perhaps important, and you decide perhaps to retire or just, you know, do it at a less intense level. But there's no reason, absolutely no reason, why you can't.
Oh yeah, and I love when the athletes actually come back after, I don't know, 20 years of a pause. You come back, they say shooting is like driving a bicycle. You know, if you know it, you know it. Also helps a lot to train, of course. And these guys do a lot of that. I don't know if you've ever seen the tennis ball things that they do.
Yeah.
I love that.
The balance thing.
Oh,
throwing
yeah.
it between the coach and themselves. Sometimes I'm a little juggle as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Bartikova gets us underway. Remember the first ranking match was a little bit literally hit and miss in the opening stages. Let's see. Let's see if this is going to be the same. Certainly not from Bartikova, the 37-year-old. Remember, an Olympic Games bronze in London. Two times European champion within the last 4 years as well. So a real chance to get the hat-trick.
Strong as well. We've seen Nicolau around the shooting range most of the days. I mean, Larnaca is her hometown, so that's pretty normal to see her around all the time. Now she's in the finals.
Yeah, the outline of Cyprus proudly on that sleeve, of course. And
oh,
there's
absolutely.
Our first miss. And it is, as always, of course, it seems inevitable from the high house on the reverse. Now
that's
Amber Hill. Listen to her pull. It's very, very, very distinctive. Very, but it can be any noise as long as you make a noise. Let's have a listen.
Yeah.
And no worries for Amber Hill.
Going in strongly.
Good
very interested for.
Yeah. Sorry, just about to say, good crowd in. For a Friday afternoon, perhaps it's lunchtime. Let's come down and see what's going on. Now, a miss for Heinonen.
I mean, I expect it's going to be a little bit more difficult for her to, because not being in the finals does really make it a little bit more then pressure for her than it is for everybody else who are a little bit more used to it, you know.
Yeah, if you've been in an Olympic Games final,
oh yeah,
this is just another day at the office. If you've waited a long time to get into or get close to, I mean, obviously,
but it's always you're always shaking. I'm sure, just even a little bit, just somewhere under the skin, you're shaking a little bit.
I think the difference is it. Instead of being, you know, paralyzed by nerves, you've just got a bit of adrenaline running.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, for sure. And this kind of sport, it's not static. It's not, you don't have to be very, very peaceful. And you're pointing at the targets. You're not really aiming, so...
It's not 10-meter air rifle, is it? Let's be sure.
Yeah.
It's a very different beast, and although we're all under the same umbrella, and the medals go under the shooting banner at events like the Olympic Games, yeah, the athletes are different creatures, shall we
say.
Absolutely,
absolutely.
Martina sitting next to me is a rifle and pistol.
Mm-hmm. Pistol, let's be clear.
Okay, I'm just giving you the same umbrella. Okay, pistol. I stand corrected.
Okay, we got some water, that's good.
Yeah, the water's turned up. That's the best news of the day. We are in the shade, but that's good news.
Yeah, it's always funny how to complain about the heat when what we're looking at are the athletes in the sun and we're in the shade the whole time.
Well, the British coach, like Amber and myself, I'm sure, they've been here whilst I've been back at home, but it's been dry at home and we moaned about that. And then it started raining heavily and we moaned about that as well.
The human condition.
Ah, well, certainly the British condition. So then, Heinonen. Coach not feeling it. Let's see what she can do here. She's just missed the one. In contention still.
Yeah, but it's just something with the targets. Okay, now she's stepping on. 30 seconds on the clock.
And the miss again, the second target, like it was on that first pair on the first station. So it is disadvantage to Heinonen at the moment.
Yeah, the coach doesn't really look very optimistic. He's not going into it very, very...
Well, you know, it's all experience as well, isn't it? You never know. It might be a sort of a rich vein of form.
Back to Bartekova.
Bartekova, who just politely asked the... we got the cameraman watching. Just strayed into vision. Just moved back slightly. I don't think that would have affected those pairs, but it is interesting, isn't it? Because some athletes will have little side blinders on, a bit like rifle and pistol. Some don't, but and some don't care. I mean, some really don't mind. You could be walking and whistling a tune, and they don't care. It just athlete to athlete.
It really depends on how you are and how you've been trained so far.
Yeah.
And I mean, Bartekova has been shooting for more than 20 years. It says since 1999. I love that. She's 37.
It was a while ago. I wonder how long it takes to pick up what talent these athletes have and start to fast track them. Nicely done. And the biggest round of applause of the afternoon for those four greens in with a chance for sure at the moment. Early days, we're on station five. If you've just joined us, remember we go 3, 4 and 5. Two pairs from 3 and 5 and just a single pair. Now Amber Hill of Great Britain.
It's a different kind of pressure to be on your home grounds. Can we say it like that? I mean, it can be supportive, but it's also... You want to give it back. You want it more, a little bit more maybe. So definitely is a double.
Hit the one for the low. Has took it at an angle. Just about got it. He's looking cool as a cucumber, isn't he? With the shades. No hint poker face, I think. That's what we would say. Now, Heinonen. Let's keep our fingers crossed. Just the two misses. Only one behind.
Not bad, actually.
Nicolau. This is the tricky one. It's unlike obviously the reverse of station three, so it's the low house you're keeping an eye on the reverse. She'll state the high house one first, hence the stance towards the left, and just misses the low house. Kept quite low, had to be said.
After 10 targets.
Shoulders go down a little bit from the athlete, perhaps from the coach as well. So 10 targets down, and just the one miss. From Bartekova, Nicolau, Hill has looked pretty good, hasn't she? That's how it's changed. Hill just nipping into the lead. The Finn, Marjut Heinonen, with a bit of work to do.
Yeah, she almost done it so smoothly under the radar. Hill just climbed up, no missing targets, nothing, just...
Like I say, she announced herself as a teenager at the European Games. Hasn't quite worked for her at the Olympics for Amber Hill.
Yeah, she was sixth at 2016.
Yep. And didn't make the final. She was close in Tokyo. Difficult, though. Really difficult for all the athletes with all the COVID problems that they had. But she is one to watch as we go forward. Potakova with a good start. Now Nikolayo. Good start, first two. Just lining up the trickier of the two, and the hands go up slowly. The referee had a little look. The side referee near me looked at the referee and then put the flag up, because from some angles you can't work it out, and that is why partly we got VAR, but partly two side referees as well.
Three of them all looking at the same target, and the athlete and the coaches. I mean,
remember her, can she make this still all green? She can. She looked comfortable on that tricky one on the reverse from the high house. And at the moment, she is ahead by one from Potakova.
Yeah, she's a very confident shooter, I think. It's how she presents herself on the station. She's just, you can see that the targets are going to go down.
Yeah. And she is one of those people who is, I think, just a mood athlete. If she's in that mood, she's in it. If she's not, it's just not her day.
Yeah.
And sometimes, you know, once you get through qualification, you get to the final stage and it's just not happening for you.
And we move to station four.
So then, round to station four. Do you know our announcer today is Petros, the competition manager.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
As all the other days as well.
He was desperate for me to mention his name. So I thought I would. Just get it out of the way. Put it out there. He's been a very good man. Looked after us very well with his crew.
Yeah, he has. He certainly has, yeah.
He's looking forward to a lion come the end of the weekend.
I mean, the whole competition, that's such a... It's a big bite to take on.
Wow.
So
hundreds of athletes.
And they really did do a great job.
Dozens and dozens of nations competing. Even there's just one continent represented here. And this is going to be a tight one, you suspect. Nicolau. Everyone in the stands, hold their breath. And there's the loudest round of applause again. Very proud of their athletes. Would love to have a medal here, get the skeet competition underway.
Yeah, but this is going to, it looks like it's going to be a pretty tight fight.
And it's the Finn who has a disadvantage.
I just love Amber Hill's shotgun. And I remember she had some problems with it in Changwon in Korea when it was pouring rain. And she couldn't close it, and she had like a tool with her, and she just closed it, and she was shooting one right after the other in that pouring rain. I don't know if it's the same shotgun anymore.
Well, it's you'll be a technician, haven't you, as well as an athlete sometimes, especially.
Oh, absolutely.
On the she's a beautician by profession, so for her, I think making sure you. A, her nails are always perfect.
Oh, absolutely.
Not that it makes any difference in the way you shoot, but also, like you say, the barrel. And the stock of that shotgun look very nice.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you can see the same thing happening, especially in the rifle and pistol 10-meter, 25-meter, because it's always shown. So all the girls have just beautiful, beautiful nails. I mean, I always see that.
I think the men just perhaps get involved as well. Why not? I like the ones where they take the they put the nation, the flag on,
oh, yeah,
on the fingers.
You can see that in at the Olympics, very much so.
Well, Bartikova.
Look at that. 6 gold medals at the European Championship.
Oh, it's familiar territory for her. Should be.
Nicolau is just a little bit behind.
Yeah, just needs to make sure she keeps hitting.
Yeah.
Remember, once we get round and finish this one, we'll see who is the first person to...
Oh, 2 flags went up. Did you see that?
Yep.
But the decision was won in the end, but the side referee did pull up 2, both of them.
Yeah, just the one, so she will be safe on bib number, if nothing else. Amber Hill doesn't want to be just safe, she wants to be top of the pile.
Absolutely. I mean, Nicolau is safe for now, then they have 10 more, and I mean, Bartikova and Hill are doing very well.
Yeah, it's turning into... Of course, it's not a battle to the end because 2 will go through in, what, just 10 shots.
20 out of 20 for Hill.
Yeah, she's looking in good nick. And the thing is, do you follow that form through into the medal match? That's the problem. You've got to ask yourself, can you keep it going? Another miss from Heinonen. That will do... That's Heinonen confirmed.
We could have expected that, but I was kind of hoping to maybe see her
in
the medal match. But when you see others, that is very, very, very hard. But she did a good job, pretty good. Only 4 missed targets. All eyes on her. She was not used to it. I mean, done a pretty good job.
Yep. And it won't do any harm to the world rankings, of course, for her. So she's ruled out, just 1 behind Nicolau, although, like I say, on the bib number, if they were level, it wouldn't have mattered. 3 left, 10 more targets each, and then we will know who will go through. A lot of work to do for Nicolau, the Cypriot, but wouldn't it be nice to have the home nation represented in the final? And here is Marjut Heinonen. I love... Again, we're talking about all the aesthetics. I love the buns.
The hair's
up out the way. You see Amber Hill just flicking the ponytail out the way. Well, no issues. No issues with the fin there. Anyway, she'll have to sit and watch, hopefully in the shade. 3 left. We need 2 out of these 3.
Yeah, did she go with her coach in the shade? Hopefully she can go in the shade now. It would not be,
I would love to tell you, but we've shaded up. We've screened a bit to our left-hand side, so...
We don't see that part.
No, I can't quite see. I'd have to go and...
Yeah, I'm not even going to try because of all the equipment in front of us. I'm not even going to try.
It's probably best not to. Probably best not to. Here we go then. Nicolau needs to have, I think, 10 out of 10 and then keep her fingers crossed.
Yeah.
And there's 1. Yeah. That's gone by the wayside. Oh, dear.
I mean, not a very favorable position to be in. You already know that. Coming in, all these thoughts in your head, you can try to stop it, but pretty normal thing to be happening. She's at 20 hits, and Hill has 4 targets to go and is at 20 hits. So...
Yeah.
Normal double goes absolutely well. I mean, this was just wonderful to watch.
Just say, Nicolau, of course, qualified 4th.
Oh, yeah.
So she will be disappointed if she doesn't make it through. But Hill, who qualified 6th, they're all on 116. We've talked about that mammoth shoot-off. Hill has, that's class for you, isn't it? When it matters, you dig in. And you please the coach, although you'd never know it. He's not smiling, is he? He's not Italian, shall we say. Yeah. Into station 4 we go. still baking in the sunshine. I don't think it's got any cooler.
Absolutely. If anything, it got hotter.
It's that kind of weather when you tuck your feet in behind you, the back of your knees start to sweat. It's that kind of weather, isn't it?
Absolutely.
They're used to it. And of course, all these ranges designed so the sun in finals, particularly over your left hand shoulder. So they're used to these conditions. Oh, another miss. It's not working, is it, at the moment?
And I just don't see a window of opportunity from both of the other athletes here for Nicolau to try and get into that.
There's a slight pause. I think there was some suggestion there might have been a VAR. There's not. So Hill's being invited into the position.
We're back at it.
And two here. And, well, Hill's almost home because she'd have to miss all of them and the Cypriot would have to hit all of them. And then on bib number, Hill would be out. But, well, it would be incredible should it happen. You never quite know. Right to station five then. Last action of this second ranking match. Bartikova has been going about her business in a very efficient manner after a couple of hiccups early on. Oh.
What a way to get down for that one.
Follow that one down.
And oh, this is what that was very nice.
Talking about the breeze in ski, particularly depending where it's coming from. We think it is coming right to left as far as we can work out. It will push the target down once in a while. Mm-hmm. And if it's gusting, it's really tricky. Nicely done. And a good round of applause and a thumbs up. Yep. Well, the coach is happy with that. Just the one miss, I think. There are two misses, but 29 on the board.
No more help for Nicolau, but she can finish off nicely. Just to finish off nicely, I mean.
Yeah, it's a shame for those in the stands who've been applauding. I think a miss on the last one from the low house. So it's not to be. It's going to be Hill and Bartikova, who will make it through. And that's a decent old final, isn't it, with Bocosi and Messerschmidt there as well.
Oh, yeah. That's going to be super tight.
Can she make it a perfect 30 for the British athletes? 7 golds in her career already at the age of 25. Hands stay down, and a round of applause from the Cypriot athlete for Amber Hill, and it is there's confirmation. Constantia Nicolaou will not make it through to the medal match.
I mean, no one has done that, right? Only Amber Hill with the 30 now.
Yeah, it was 27 for Bocosi. Amber Hill will have the advantage of the number one on her back.
Oh, yeah,
she qualifies. So does Bartikova with 29. Very high quality second ranking match. Nicolau Heinonen will not make it through. And, well, as we say, Bartikova and Hill joining Messerschmidt and Bocosi. And that is the next action. It is the medal match, and that's coming next.
I looked at it, I remember what you said. I said, form over fashion. But geez, I looked at the weather forecast, and the other one is going to go next 2 days. T-shirt on tonight.
Yeah, do you have other ones for, like...
should have heard.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a few minutes we proceed with the metal match. Number 4, representing Germany, Nadine Messerschmidt.
The heat is still quite strong, and we are ready though for our medal match in the women's skeet competition here at the European Championships. Nadine Messerschmidt, we saw in that first ranking match, second in that. And then Bocosi was first, but 27 out of 30 was behind both Barkova and Hill.
Danka Batekova.
Bocosi, of course, Olympic gold and silver medalists at the last two games, respectively. But, well, Batekova in with a chance. She looked very good, didn't she? But not quite as good as the British athlete, the youngster Amber Hill. Seven goals to her name. Wouldn't she like to make it eight here? Four athletes, slightly different in the way that it works. We have 10 targets, sorry, 20 targets to four, 10 targets to bronze, and another 10 targets to gold and silver. And if it's tied after gold and silver, we will have a shoot-off. If it's too far ahead for one athlete, we will stop it there and then. So that's how it's going to work. Our officials have been introduced. Sadly, no, for the locals, no local. Constantia Nicolaou not making it through in ranking match number two. Mm.
But that's why the referee is from Cyprus now. He can be from Cyprus. We have four nations and two quota places.
Oh yes, don't forget the Olympic quota. I'm going to make a note of that in case I do, because it's early in the cycle, the first time you can get your quota places, of course.
Absolutely, but a very, very nice time to get it.
Also quota places, I believe, at the European 25 and 50 meter.
Melis Girarda jury, she just sat down on her place with all the coaches, checking out if everything's okay with them as well.
Yeah, don't mess with her. She sees everything. Yeah,
absolutely. All right, starting strong now. Hill and Bartekova just came out of the ranking match number two. Bocosi and Messerschmidt could maybe have had a little bit of time to relax after the ranking matches.
Well, and also Hill didn't miss. Bartekova with just the one miss. Richard Bricknell again. Poker face.
Hill is continuing on in that manner. I mean, four greens for her.
How can the Slovakian respond? Remember, this is the one where you want to make sure you get the high house, and that will put you in good manner of form. Stefan Zemko watching on. Both Bricknell and Zemko will be happy with how it's gone so far. Perhaps spoke a little bit too soon. Well, that's only the second in the ranking match and the medal match, but early on.
She got low to follow that one out, but unfortunately it was already a miss.
Well, we saw that, didn't we, in the second ranking match just a while ago, having to sort of almost like crouch down as you're trying to follow the flight. Bocosi starting well, Benelli looking calm.
Oh, yeah, so far.
So far.
So far.
Well, good start from Hill, from Bocosi. Not a disaster from Bartekova. Now then, Axel Kramer watching Messerschmidt.
Would be lovely to get that quota. As you said 5 days away from her birthday?
Something like that.
Something like that. And last Olympics, she was fifth. So hopefully this is her day.
Oh, I've just double-checked. It's a month and 5 days.
Oh, okay. All right.
Well, you know, you're allowed one per commentary, aren't you?
Oh, look, we're already at the, and I like to call this one, the central station.
Well, it is in the center. I don't think I can't fault your logic. Station number four.
Because it gets confusing for some people knowing that they're shooting at 3, 4, 5, but then it's like, oh, where is 1 and 2? And, you know.
First miss from Amber Hill.
Oh, wow.
There's a collector's item. I was about to say, it's a lot more confusing if you watch qualification because they go around, it's 8 or 9, isn't it? And some are singles, some are doubles. And the athletes know, of course.
Of course.
They come right round tight to the low house and the high house. Yeah, it's interesting to watch the qualification. So Hill with the one miss, Bartekova with the one miss, Bocosi looking good at the moment. moment. No, having to take a step back. I looked up at the scoreboard and there were two greens up there, which was amazing considering she hadn't actually taken the shot, which is why there was a pause, I think.
That's going to be a mess for her as well.
Well, it's even Stevens at the moment, which gives Messerschmidt, the woman who qualified top, but finds herself with the lowest bib number in the medal match, mm-hmm. a little chance just to edge ahead.
All right.
That's nicely done. That's a Kramer. With a little round of applause for his charge.
We still have a long way to go, though.
Yeah, we certainly do. But remember, once we've been round here, and then we come round again. Yeah, she started young, didn't she? 15 in the World Cup, and then I think it was 17 in the European Games. I could be wrong. It could be 16, actually, but certainly very young. So, you know, a decade of, even though she's 25, of collecting medals. I think we said it was 7, wasn't it? Golds in different formats.
I mean, some people just know what they're born for. And she was one of them.
Yeah.
Okay, but they go out. Coming in with 30 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, they certainly know, and certainly someone who's, as we mentioned before, is so adept at winning golds at the European Championships. They know their rhythm, their timings. Amber Hill would love to get a quota place. You may recall she was all set to head off, had the little party to set her on her way, and then tested positive for COVID and stayed in the UK watching it from home.
I mean, that whole situation really, really did put away and change a lot of things and put some things into perspective as well.
Yes. I mean, I was lucky enough to go out there and to the Paralympics. It was seven weeks out there in fairly tight restrictions, but certainly a lovely country. Would love to go back there again and get outside of Tokyo. Wasn't allowed outside of Tokyo, technically. Well, this is good from Station 5 from everybody so far. Can Pocosi come to the party?
You can see hear the music in the background. The one that you hear in Cyprus most frequently.
Absolutely.
In the streets, everywhere you go.
You can tell you've been here 3 weeks.
Oh, yeah.
You're dreaming it.
Absolutely.
Messerschmidt.
It's my alarm in the morning, you know.
Messerschmidt doing well. European champion in Osijek.
Only Messerschmidt with 10. Everybody else with 9 hits. I mean, it's going to be interesting to see this through.
Yeah, remember, we go around another loop, so to speak. So 3, 4, and 5. The three most central targets, and that's what we don't want to see, is the target being broken by the protective fence.
Oh, yeah.
Stefan Zenko didn't enjoy that one either. We're already underway as we watch Messerschmidt. It looks easy, doesn't it, in slow motion? But you can see just how quick they have to be, and Amber Hill nabs all 4 as we watch some of the action from that first 10 targets per athlete. But now they can hardly watch. Who'd be a coach? Normally very strong, of course, the Italians, the British, Slovakians, Germans coming on as well, but when it comes to the world stage, which is coming up, of course, the Americans. I see the Americans looking and jostling. Out on the Rangers. But here, who will be top of the pile when it comes to Europe's top skeet shooters? We're getting very close to finding out. Good first station for all the athletes. Now Messerschmitt.
Benelli is starting with his...
He's a man, you know what he's thinking. You know what he's thinking.
Yeah, and he does not hide behind the poker face whatsoever.
No, I don't think he'd be good at cards. Unless he was double bluffing. Messerschmitt takes all four. Nicely done. Benelli and Kramer with a little conversation.
I mean, being in the finals, shooting in the medal match, shooting one right after the other, and with the big number four, she was behind, you know. I mean, only one miss to make a pretty big difference here. It's almost as if they're doing a shoot-off throughout the whole medal match. It's that high of stakes. Coming to Bacozzi. Two times Olympic medalist, I mean.
Yeah, not much will faze her. And you wouldn't rule her out getting a Olympic quota the first time of asking. Remember, we're getting close to seeing who will be on the podium, and then another 10 targets will know who has gold and silver and a quota place in their back pockets.
Oh, yeah.
Not literally, of course. I don't think... I don't wonder, you get any bit of paper, would you? You must do, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, we're round to station five, or as Martina would say, the right-hand one.
The last one.
The last one. It will be the last one for one of these athletes.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it is very tight. Messerschmitt with a slight advantage, but it may mean nothing. Hill will get us underway. And she nabs those two. This will be important. She has the number one bib. So one will do, but she'd like two.
Mm-hmm.
And two she gets. Just the one miss for her so far. Bartikova of Slovakia next up. Invited there by our referee. And then the clock starts to run down.
That was the junior skeet. For a second there, we could see that. Results back to... But I mean, these... They're just shooting like machines. I mean, what? In the sun, after the two ranking matches, after the days of qualifications.
And that's nicely done, Bartikova. Make sure she stays in this competition. So the pressure on Bacozzi. She needs all four. And then just see what Messerschmitt does. Will it be the most decorated, the most experienced athlete who goes out first?
But what can faze you after winning the gold medal at the Olympics anymore? What?
Well, she'd like the quota, wouldn't she? That's for sure. She hits those. So she's on 19 as well, but she has the lowest... bib number. Let's see what Messerschmitt can do here, because she needs all four. She's halfway there.
Reverse double on the last station.
Yeah, coming out the low house, of course, the tricky one. And no target.
Didn't
come out of the low house, just to add to her discombobulation.
Oh, yeah.
A No problems for her. 20.
All right.
So from being in danger of going out, she's top of the pile. That's how tight it has been. She's perfect through the first 20. Everybody else just missing the one. And that means that Diana Bocosi, well, she will have to take fourth place. She will miss out the woman who is an Olympic gold medalist and a silver medalist. Well, a world champion as well. But it just goes to show, if it's not your day, it's not your day. And look how close it has been.
I mean, I wouldn't even call it not being the way that these women were shooting today was just over the top. Everything was on the count of the beat number, on the count of the ranking match.
So three misses in 80.
Yes.
Yeah, it's not a lot, is it? But it's enough. And
absolutely.
Also, that we were talking about how important it was to have a decent first ranking match. So she hit 27, not a disgrace. And she was top of that ranking match. But of course, in the end, Hill was perfect. And Bartikova just the one miss. So they went 1 and 2 on the bibs.
Yeah, ranking match number 2 was a bit stronger than ranking match number 1.
Certainly was in terms of quality in that, in that snapshot.
Normal double going. I mean, it's not even well anymore. It's just the way that it's supposed to go. I feel like, you know, saying, oh yeah, great job is just...
It's when you miss is when you're surprised,
I guess.
And
we
always talk about that reverse from the high house. I'm sorry if I'm going on everybody, but it is the one the athletes do find the trickiest, just the changing angles from hitting the low, then trying to twist and head towards the right-hand side, not perhaps the easiest. But these athletes, we didn't see it in the ranking matches so much, but we are seeing it here, and the coaches will be thinking, you know, I've done a good job here, haven't I? Again, just having to chase the last one, not hitting it. So another miss for the Slovakian. We haven't said that very often about anybody here, have we?
Oh,
particularly
yeah.
Not Messerschmidt.
Ooh!
I don't spoke too
you
soon.
Called it. Yeah, absolutely. All right.
A little adjustment of the glasses from Axel Kramer.
It's definitely getting steamier here.
Well, there's a hint of a little smile from him. I don't think that was what we call a Richter smile, where he wasn't really meaning it, was he? There we are. That's
okay.
Better.
Yeah.
Little fist pump.
Yeah.
You're back on it.
It's okay.
It's not a disaster.
I mean, she has fought very, very strongly and very well until now.
Well.
And even from now on, but just...
Well, I think for the German coach, would love the gold medal. They're all assured a medal, but what they would absolutely want is to be in the top 2. If you're going to miss out on gold, well, you miss out on gold. But get in that top 2.
Mm-hmm.
Get the quota. But it gets more complicated as we go through towards Paris 24 because, of course, some nations will have all their quotas and it can go down a bit further and sometimes it goes down into qualification. But for the time being, as we start this process, it's very simple.
Oh, is that going to be... Okay.
That's better. No problems there. And she remains in the joint lead alongside Amber Hill. And now we'll find out who's going to get the bronze from this station number 5 away on our right-hand side. Hill and Messerschmidt will want to keep it very solid. Remember, Bocosi already out. Messerschmidt with big number 4.
Mm. Almost like easy breezy.
Oh, let's not jinx it.
Oh, no, yeah, no. I meant for the ones that are already passed.
Oh, you see what you mean.
Not saying the ones.
I'm with you.
The ones coming, I'm not going to say anything about them. All right. Oh.
Well, that is a quarter place for Amber Hill. Can Messerschmidt join the party? The master ranks of the British support team and some of the athletes there cheering her on. Wow. looking to put pressure on Messerschmitt, doing a good job so far.
Oh yeah, but also just going through the finals the best that she can, focusing on that next two ones.
Ooh, no, a miss. And, well, Messerschmitt has a target of three. These four.
Okay, two are down. But that's it, right?
Well, you would think she'll get at least one. She does get at least one. Misses the reverse from the low house. And it is Barkova who will take the bronze, but miss out on that Olympic quota place. Well, such fine margins. That miss right at the end is the miss that she'll be rueing. It would have put her into the last two with the bib number advantage, but not to be. Not to be. We're down to two. And whatever happens, it's a good day on the range at their office for these two. Hill with the advantage of just one target. We've got another 10 targets per athlete. Remember, we can have that golden lift. We can stop if one athlete is too far ahead and the maths just doesn't work.
Oh, yeah.
But it's very tight. You think this might go all the way around.
But I think it's so much different to continue on now knowing the quota places. To Germany and Great Britain. And now it's just the decision of the place on the podium for these two.
Well, the British will be happy. Remember, all the way back, into August, Lucy Hall getting a silver in the trap, getting an Olympic quota place.
Yeah.
And Amber Hill has been holding the standard for British shotgun. She's got a few compatriots alongside her now who are starting to show some good promise in the different disciplines. Mm-hmm. But this will be interesting. And Hill missed that reverse. Again, poker face.
Absolutely.
Richard Bricknell not letting anything in his facial expressions. But Messerschmitt now level. Well,
okay.
It's certainly interesting. Remember, we will go to a shoot-off for the gold and silver.
If
it ties.
Or you're just calling it now.
Yeah, well, wouldn't that be a skill? It'd be a bit boring if you knew what's going to happen, I guess. But I guess you might get rich at the bookies. That's better from Amber Hill. Messerschmitt then, of course, a bit, as you were talking about, being a bit like the shoot-off. If you shoot first, you bag them, you put the pressure. Now it's the turn of Kramer to clap his hands enthusiastically, as if he can will his athlete to better things. It's not going to happen. He has to take his seat, be assured he's done his bit, and just trust the athlete.
Last four targets?
Possibly.
No problem, I mean, for the competition. For the finals, it is.
Let's see.
Everything else is a shoot-off, but okay. I mean, Hill just holds the pressure very well.
If you can get the two here, then it will be interesting to see how Messerschmitt does react to it, respond to it.
Absolutely.
And she does. Just got a nibble on the right-hand side of that last target. So, where do we go from here? Pressure on these last two targets, particularly the last one out of the low house.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was a miss. And Amber Hill puts her hands to her head. She can't believe it.
Absolutely.
What drama at the end here. And it came down to Amber Hill keeping the pressure on. And she gets her eighth career gold. And, well, hasn't she been outstanding? And not only the quota place, but the gold medal as well. And the celebrations will start. Congratulations to Nadine Messerschmidt. Disappointment in missing out on that gold. She takes the silver, but she does get an Olympic quota place as well.
Yeah, absolutely. But for me, it's really interesting how Amber Hill was holding her head as if she was surprised. I mean, what are you surprised about? The way you were shooting today, that's absolutely what goes. The Messerschmidt, I mean, was excellent as well. But what Amber did in the ranking match.
Well, the medal ceremony coming up, the British contingent will, as we know, sadly have to learn new words to their anthem. But they'll be very proud all the same, of course. Amber Hill takes the gold and gets the hugs as well. An emotional time for the 25-year-old, and I think, you know, disappointment, that last little hiccup for Messerschmidt, but she's on the podium,
and
she's smiling
quote,
as well.
Absolutely. I mean, I would be smiling if I were her.
Well, this is the end game, so to speak, looking at that target.
she knew it.
Yeah, there it is, the one that got away. Never mind, a hug from Kramer, the coach. Anyway, Amber Hill, well, a little tear from time to time, but why not? And, well, Richard Bricknell showing some emotion, kept it cool all the way through. But, yeah, well done to Amber Hill. And there we go, there's confirmation of the three athletes who have made it to the podium. Bronze for Bartkova of Slovakia, Messerschmidt of Germany with the silver, and it's gold for Great Britain and Amber Hill.
I did it.